as we were studying the chapter hurting direct and indirect proportion, exercise 13.2, today we will start with question number 9 of this exercise. In this question it is saying, a car takes 2 hours to reach a destination by travelling at the speed of 60 km per hour. Okay, so a car, it takes 2 hours to reach the destination by travelling at speed of 60 km per hour. This is speed is given to you as 60 km per hour. Suppose this is point A, and when it starts traveling, it will reach after 2 hours at point B. Means if A, it will start with a speed of 60 km per hour. So within 2 hours it will reach the destination at point B. Okay, now what it is saying, how long will it take when the car travel at the speed of 80 km per hour? Here the same destination is there. Okay, the same destination is there, but here the speed it is saying, speed here it is given to you as 80 km per hour. Okay, here it was given 60 km, here 80 km, means 20 km is increased, means speed is increased by here by 20 km. Now here the speed was 60 km, so time taken here was 2 hours. Now you have increased the speed. Okay, so at what time this car will reach the destination point B? Okay, so here as you have seen, here you are getting a condition of inverse proportion. How come you are getting the condition of inverse proportion? If speed is increasing, the time will decrease, and if the speed is decreased, the time is increasing. So here you are getting a condition of inverse proportion. So let's draw. Here the parameter given to you is as speed of the car, it is given to you speed of car and time per hour. Okay, so speed is given to you as 60 km and the time taken is, when it travels at the speed of 60 km, time it is taking to travel to reach the destination is 2 hours. And when the speed of the car will be 80 km, you have to find out the time. So let's suppose the time be x, as this is the condition of inverse proportion. So this will be 60 into 2 will be equal to 80 into x. This 2 and this 2 will get multiplied. From here you will get 60 into 2, and this is in multiplication, this will come in division. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. This is 2 1s are 2 4s are 2 3s are 2 2s are. So from here you will get x equal to 3 by 2. Divide this, you will get 2 1s are 2 this. So from here, this 1 and whole, this is the remainder and 2. So this will be equal to how much? 1 and half hour. So here x will be equal to how much? 1 and half hour. Okay. So if the speed is 60 km, time taken to reach the destination is 2 hours. When you increase the speed, it is 80 km, so time will be decreased. So when the speed is 80 km per hour, the speed is, the time is decreased, that is 1 and half hours. So this is the answer. Question number 10 of exercise 13.2. In this, here you are having two questions. Question says that 2 person could fit new window in a house in 3 days. If two number of persons are 2, so they can fit a new window in a house in 3 days. Okay, so the first condition here it is saying one of the person fell ill, means one of the person, if he fell ill before the work is started. So two persons were there, one has fell ill before the work is started. So how many persons are remaining? One person. So one person is remaining. Before the work is started, how long would the job take now? So you have to find out the time. Okay. Second condition is there, how many person would be needed to fit the window in one day? Means here number of person it is not given to you. Number of days it is given to you as 1 day. Okay. So let me write down the parameters here. Parameter, what are the parameters given to you is the number of days is given to you and the number of person is given to you. So I am writing with number of person and second it is given to you as number of days. So the first annotation saying two person could fit the window in 3 days, means number of person is 2 and they can fit the window is how many days? 3 days. Okay. The second condition is saying that if one person fell ill, means out of 2, one has fell ill before the work has started. So how many remaining? One person is remaining. So you have to find out the time, number of days in which the work it will be completed by one person. So here let us suppose the number of days when this number of person is 1 be x. Okay. Now the second condition it is saying how many person would be need to fit the window in 1 day. So here the number of days is given to you as 1 day. You have to find out the number of person here. So let the number of person here be 1. So two questions are there. We will solve one by one. So for the first part, as it is, you have to find out whether the question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion. So from here, if you increase the number of person, the time will decrease, because more person, less time, less person, and if you decrease the number of person, time taken will be more. So more person, less time, less person, more time. So this is the question for inverse proportion. Okay. So here for the first question we are solving. So this will be, we will take this 2. So this will be 2 into 3 will be equal to 1 into x. So this will be 2 into 3 equal to x and this one will be 1. So this will be 6 by 1 equal to x, or from here x equal to 6. So for here x equal to 6. So number of days is 6 days. So for here you will get number of days is 6 days. Means if one person is doing this work, how many days it will take? It will take 6 days to complete for that single person. Now for the second part, it is saying how many person would be need to fit the window in 1 day. If the number of days is 1, you have to find out the numbers of person here. So now you will take this 2. So this will be, this is the condition of inverse proportion only. So this will be 2 into 3 equal to y into 1. So here 2 into 3 is 6. This is y by 1. Or you can write down y equal to 6. So now this is 6. Here 6 is the number of persons. Means 6 person will be needed to fit that window in 1 day. Question number 11. In this question it is saying a school has 8 period a day, each of 45 minutes. Okay. In a day, 8 periods are there in a school and each period it is of how much? 45 minutes. Okay. How long would each period be if the school has 9 periods? Means here the number of period is increased. It is 9 periods. So you have to find out the number of minutes each period will have, assuming the school hours to be the same. In both the condition, given to you? Number of, what are the parameters given to you? Number of periods and duration of time is given to you. Okay, so when number of period is given to you as 8, so when the number of period is 8, in a 8 periods are there, so each period will be of 45 minutes. So if the number of period is increased, means 9 minutes will be there, so you have to find out the number of minutes. That means you have to find out the number of duration of time. So let the duration of time be x here. So here you have to find out whether the, like, this question is of direct proportion or indirect proportion. So in this condition, if you see, if you increase the number of period, time duration will be decreased because you are having same school hours, okay? And you, if you decrease the number of periods, the time period will be increased, because if period will be less, you will get more time. So the time period of that particular subject will be, or that particular subject will be what? More. So period increase, time will be decreased. If period is decreased, the time will be increased. So this is the condition of inverse proportion. So in inverse proportion, we multiply this two, that means 8 into 45, this will be 9 into x. So this will be 8 into 45 upon 9 equal to x. Okay, so this will be 3 3s are 9, 3 1s are 3 5s are. 3 1s are 3 5s are. So 5 8s are is how much? 40. X equal to 40 minutes. From here you can see, like, 40 minutes. Means each period, when the number of period is 8, so the time taken here will be 45 minutes, and if you increase the number of periods, that is 9, so the time taken will be 45 minutes. So here you have seen that period is less, time period will be more. If period is more, time period will be less. So this is the condition of inverse proportion. I hope you have understood this chapter, and you people might have studied how to understand that whether the question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion, because here in the question, in the exam, you will not be given with that this question is in direct proportion or indirect proportion. You have to find out whether the question is in direct or indirect. So keep solving this, and if you have any doubt regarding this chapter, you can ask me. Thank you for today.